Sai Ram, I'm still getting questions from so many devotees world over seeking clarifications on certain current issues. Still getting, I thought that chapter is closed. But the confusion is of that dimension that people are restless, doubts multiplied, false claims increasing, and they feel that some clarification is necessary. So they're bombarding me with some genuine questions. I think it's my responsibility to clarify the doubts to the extent I can. Let us see. Before I go into the topic, questions, clarifications. Clarifications to clear confusions and false claims. Let me emphatically make it clear, time and again, that all the answers are from Swami discourses only. In every talk I say that. Why? Because when Bhagavan said so many things, you don't need to give your own interpretation. So they are all from Sai literature only. I do not own a single statement. So that's not my imagination, purely from Sai literature. Broadly speaking, I got questions which I classified into some headings, headlines, but there's still more. Before I go, to establish my authenticity, credibility and the quality, is all the bunch of Swami's talks. Bunch of Swami's talks. From, you'll be seeing all underlines and all that. From the bunch of talks only, I have been trying to classify them and quote them freely, appropriate to the question. Okay, sir? The bunch is here for ready reference for your information. The first set about miraculous happenings. So many miracles have been happening. How shall we take them? How shall we take them? Baba himself said, in the year 1965, you can imagine how long back, March 3rd, at Amalapuram in Andhra Pradesh, East Godavari. Again in the year 1970, on 22nd November, in Prashantralayam, he explained the same point. Why miraculous happenings? Why miracles? He said it. What did he say? Miraculous happenings at an amazing nature take place in order to make known my majesty, my glory as the divine that has incarnated. In other words, to let them know that God has come on earth, that Baba is God incarnate. He allows, he wills these miraculous happenings so that we'll be convinced of his divinity. That's what he said. My majesty and my glory. Bhagavan at another time he said that they are like visiting cards. I think I am clear. Again now he said, because of miraculous things happening everywhere, miracles happening everywhere, to let us know his divinity, majesty and glory, this situation is misused by persons. Misused, even in those days. You can understand, it's not of today, they are misused. how they are misused in the same talks. 1965, March 3rd, 1970, 22nd November. He explains how these miraculous happenings are misused by people. People make use of these things for their personal propaganda and aggrandizement, self-projection, self-glorification. They may misuse Swami's miracles. Second, they abuse to trade for money. To trade for money. How? Some people say, Vibhuti is falling from our photographs. Amrutam is dripping from the pictures of Baba at my house. And thus they collect money. This is one way of misusing the divine miracle. Again on 3rd March 1965, I am ready with all the discourses as a member of the parliament in defense of my argument. Anybody can say that. 3rd March 1965, how people misuse. Some people think that they are superior devotees. Why? Vibhuti is falling from pictures, I see. Some people think they are of top grade in devotion. Why? Amrit is dripping from the pictures. Nonsense. Nonsense. Feeling that they are superior devotees, they confer boons and blessings on innocent folks. These are the sentences straight from Bhagavan Baba. Therefore, we should never misuse these gifts of grace as a sign of our superiority in the path of devotion. In devotion, there is no class like superior and inferior unless one is an ass. One will never realize that there is a class structure in the path of devotion. True devotion means all are same, all are one, that's all. You cannot say you are superior to me. I cannot consider myself inferior to you. All are same. And then how we misuse, Baba says this. What should we do? When people misuse, when people trade on his miracles, what should we do? Consider such people as cheats and crooks. Swami's discourses. Because some people think that Anil Kumar is very forceful, so he talks like that. Forceful things should be put forcefully. Forceful things cannot be put mildly. So we should consider those that misuse miracular powers as cheats and crooks, as Baba himself said. And then, what does he suggest? Any such person should be immediately removed. See that? Swami's words are fiery, fiery. Should be immediately removed from our Sai centers and Sai units. Who are they? Those that think superior. Those who are attached to them should be removed. Those that encourage them should be removed immediately. Then next category of questions on medium. Medium, Baba is speaking through me as if he is a mic. Baba wants me to tell you. Or he can tell you directly. Why should he tell me to tell you? Why mediator? Why medium? Why we don't understand that simple logic? Do you need somebody to tell you what Swami wants you to do? No medium, that's all. It's not Anil Kumar that said it. 1965, March 3rd, Amalapuram. 1962, November 25th at Prashantalayam, he said that there is no medium. 1962-1965. Bhagavan knows that that category of people will be more, and that some of us who are really innocent, most of us who are ignorant, will fall a prey into their hands. Therefore he said long back, no medium, nothing whatsoever. What does he say about it? Let me quote. I have no media, no medium, nor do I need substitutes. I cannot represent Baba. I am Baba. Shut up. You cannot be Baba. You cannot represent him. No. Why? He is only one without the second. No duplicate. No carbon copy. No photostat copy. No. He is the only one without the second. He said, I don't need any medium, no substitutes or subsidiaries or representatives. I have no representatives, no substitutes, nothing doing. That's what Swami said. On 15th October 1999, he tells us how to handle such fellows. If a man telling that Swami speaks through me, I listen to his voice and tell you as if you are stupid. He will tell you what he wants. He is God. He can talk to you directly. He doesn't need any other third person. What is all this? Swami clearly said, how we should treat those people who consider themselves as medium, intermediate people. What does he say? What are Swami's comments? They must be insane or suffering from hysteria or possessed by some ghost. Clear? So if I act as a medium, it means I am insane or hysteric or possessed by some ghost. I cannot be his medium. That's what Baba said. And further, 15th October 1999, he said, if anyone says Swami speaks through me, understand it. It is not I that speaks through them. No. I don't speak through them. Consider them that they are agents, brokers and cheats. Heavy bombing. Consider them as brokers, cheats. That's what he said. Now you can have what Swami said about this particular medium who claims that Swami speaks through me. No.